I can't just sit here all day while you rub a ball patch into your head.
Lay it out for me again.
Damn it, Jim, are you deaf?
I just don't get it. You're saying Tawny is protecting Roald Dahl?
What? I'm protecting Roald Dahl. I never even mentioned Tawny. Tawny is clueless. Half the guys be throwing the cells knife tonight are there because of Roald Dahl's gear. And Tawny still hasn't flinched.
What's so special about the gear?
Regular junkie have a nasty come down. You've seen all the assholes we booked in the past, going crazy from withdrawals, scratching up their arms, sending them nuts.
A few of them died when I was a rookie.
Exactly. This stuff's like the multivitamins of gear. Keeps the user healthy. Gives their body what it needs. Shit, it even puts them to sleep at a reasonable hour. But above all, the high is... well, sky high. Roald knows that the customer, even if they're covered in dirt, is king. If you go around selling dirty junk, the customers disappear. This stuff keeps your clientele alive and hooked.
Who is Roald Dahl?
You think I know? Even if I knew, I wouldn't tell you. You think I'm stupid?
What's my role in this?
We get shipments every week at the dock. We're pretty much the point men.
Security?
Point men.
Sounds like security to me.
And I bet a sigh sounds like a moan to you, too.
So what? I get a call from Roald and we get to work?
No. Roald talks to Tools. Tools calls me. I call you. But first, you gotta buy a stake. So you're invested. 5 large.
A stake? You didn't say that before. I don't have that kind of cash laying around. I thought you were helping me out.
I am.
No, you're not. You're like the Avon lady whose job it is to make more Avon ladies.
There's major ducats in this.
Did you have to buy a stake?
Hell no, I'm a cop. Better than that, I'm a crooked cop. I'm an asset to people like this. I was welcomed with open arms.
Crooked cops are a dime a dozen in this city. I was a crooked cop.
Was? Now you're just crooked. I don't see a lot of options for you, Jim. So you'll find the money, won't you?
What if I can get Sniff in on the action? Can get like a finder's fee or something.
No! You don't bring that Boy Scout into this.
But he could be like, quality assurance.
You can try and sell him to me all you like. I'm not the one who calls the shots. If you bring him in on this, shit will fall apart. They'll kill you quickly, bullet to the head. Me? They'll let me live, but I'll have a lot of missing pieces to remind me of that mistake. I'm telling you, no Sniff. Now get out of my car. Shipment is due next Friday. Get the cash by then. When you got the money, call the Lapkus Motel. Leave a message for room 16. I'll know it was you.
What then?
We'll be in business. Police, step away from the prostitutes, sir.
Sniff, it's Jimmy.
What do you want, Jimmy?
Wondering if you want to get a bite to eat.
I don't think so.
Come on. I never see you no more.
Yeah, there's a reason for that, Jim. Why would I want to eat with you?
I want to say sorry, and I ain't gonna settle for it being over the phone.
Fine.
Harris's Diner at 10?
Fine.
Great. See you there, Sniff. It'll be fine. Once they understand Sniff, they'll worship me. Wow, Jim, you were right. If we hadn't listened to you about Sniff, we would have been selling powdered milk to our customers. Let me buy you a beer. Jesus Christ, Sniff! It's all right, everyone. Police here. The gun malfunctioned.
I gotta get out of here. Don't ever contact me again, Jimmy.
Hey, you! You're a dead man. Your friend could have killed someone.
It's fine, sir. See, I have the gun. It's just faulty.
So what?
It was just an accident. Happens every day.
Well, this accident is gonna cost me the repair of that chair. Maybe even some therapy for my waitresses.
Listen, pal, I got a 20.
Oh, screw you, friend. I'm calling the cops.
I am a cop.
No, you're not. I heard about you. Andy told me you were fired for murder.
I didn't kill nobody.
Still get fired. Wait here, I'm calling the cops.
Oh, no. What am I gonna do? I'm a joke. Should I run? No. Andy don't like me enough to keep my mouth shut about this. Wait, this is Artie's beat. He'll help me out. I hope he'll still let me in on Roald Dahl's crew.
What's the situ... Jim? What did you do?
I didn't do nothing, it was Sniff. But the gun malfunctioned, I swear, no foul play.
Nichols, you go questioning the witness. Jim, you come here.
Will do. Alright, which one of you mamacitas wants to chat with a boy in blue?
Come here, Jim. What the hell really happened?
I don't know. I was telling Sniff about our plans with Roald Dahl and he whipped out his piece. Then he went mental because of his nose and dropped the gun. That's when it went off.
You told him about Roald?
Only his name, nothing more.
His name is a lot more than people know about him right now. I told you not to rope Sniff into this. Now he's gonna suspect something.
He won't think nothing. He's not the shining badge we worked with no more. He looks depressed. Looks like shit. Smells worse. His nose don't work and he has no job. You gotta be a guy like me who's used to playing around in the bedrock to bounce back from something like that.
You're the poster boy of inspiration. You better hope you're right. Can't have that bastard anywhere near this business.
Most of them just heard a shot, but your ex-wife says you and Sniff were getting pretty heated, Jim. You know how it is, Nichols. Talking about old cases. Yeah, I guess so. Remember the guy dressed in the state dress, Artie? Called himself State Jesus. Yeah, he was a wife beater in the end.
Go secure the area or something, Nichols.
No problem.
Are you a real cop, then?
What do you mean, am I a real cop?
Well, this joker here says he's a cop.
Yeah, he is.
I thought he was fired.
No, he wasn't. Got a problem?
No, I guess I was mistaken.
Would you like to press any charges today?
I suppose not. I just thought he was a crook, that's all.
I suggest you get back in that kitchen and keep flipping burgers then, Mr.
Kerman. Alan Kerman.
Well, if everything's okay here, we'll be on our way, Mr. Kerman.
All right then. Goodbye, officer.
Start warming up the cruiser, Nichols.
Thanks for helping me out of that bind, Artie.
Just don't let it happen again. I don't want to be responsible for you around Roald Dahl. You gotta shape up if you're serious about this. It ain't the force, no rule book or wrist slaps. You fuck up, you'll pay the penalty in a much more creative way. How's the money coming along?
I don't know. I got 20 bucks, and I'm almost out of cigarettes.
Jesus. Here, come to this address tonight around 10 o'clock. It's a temporary hideout while the heat dies down from my last deal. Some taxi driver got killed in the getaway. Tools will be there. You can make a deal with him yourself. He might front you the startup cash. You'll pay him back with interest, of course.
You're a pal, Art.
See you tonight.
4564 Maryland Avenue. Oh, what a good pal. He's a good pal. He'd save my life if it came to it. We're good pals. We're good friends. He'd save my life. What if I kill myself? Yeah.
On top of the flapjacks, caught in careful halves, sits two pretty strawberries and two whole giraffes.
Come on, fatso, time to go to bed.
Hey, I ain't fat. I ought to sue you.
Process him, Nichols. I'm going to see the chief.
Gee, thanks for the help. This asshole weighs more than you.
For that, you can watch the asshole's vomit from the back seat.
Damn it.
That incident at the diner... Oh, sorry, Chief, didn't realize you had company.
That's all right, Artie. Please come in. You may be able to offer some help to the task force here.
Task force?
I'm Agent Campbell. This is my partner, Agent Stillwater.
We're here because your city has seen a significant increase in drug trafficking in the past 6 months. Tani told us that checks out with the rate of overdoses being called in around the city. Have you seen any changes on the street level?
Sure, of course I have. Been on the job as long as I have, change isn't just the thing in your pocket. Only thing that stays the same is the smell of piss.
We're talking specifically about the last 6 months, officer.
I guess. Junkies are dying as quickly as they're being made nowadays. I don't mean to be unhelpful, but the job is just the job after a while. What's the difference between now and the last time there was new game in the city?
New game? Do you know something we don't?
If there's more shipments, there must be new game in the city, right? Makes sense.
Hell, this guy should be on the task force. We need brains like that.
We're at your disposal, agents. Nothing is more important to us than cleaning the streets and making them safe.
Yeah, whatever you folks need.
Hey, sorry to barge in, Chief, but we got a big one.
What is it, officer?
Body's been found by the landlord of an apartment on Maryland Avenue. Operator who spoke with him said it was chopped up and thrown away in the trash.
What's the address again?
4564 Maryland Avenue.
Oh, tough part of town. I got this one, Chief. I'll let you get back to the agents. Nice meeting you. I look forward to working with you and your team. Nichols, we got a call.
Can I turn on the siren?
Just hurry up.
Everyone clear away. You touch it, we cuff you. You struggle, we bag you. Holy shit, Sniff's here, Artie. How's it going, Sniff? You live in... Hold on.
You live in this dump?
Jesus, Sniff, times are tough.
I think I should check this one out.
What do you think you're doing? Nickel, stop him.
You've been bossing me around all day. Do it yourself.
I gotta go inside, find the landlord.
Artie!
Shush. Don't you know what's going on downstairs?
The body in the trash? Yeah, that was one of my boys. He's a PI. Caught him poking his nose around last night. Little weasel. Screamed up a storm.
I can't help you with this one. Why didn't you call?
I don't need you cleaning my mess. I can do it myself.
By throwing it in the trash? Next to the building it happened in?
Genius, right? Who'd guess it was one of us?
I don't know. Sniff Bloodhound, maybe?
From school? What's he got to do with it?
He lives in this building.
Really? If I knew, I would have said hello.
We're all dead. What are we gonna do?
You got nothing to worry about, Artie.
Tools, can I talk to you in the kitchen?
Sure.
Hello, Artie.
How are you, Grandma Minkle?
I'm good, sweetie.
Good to hear.
Tools, you goddamn idiot. You put a body in the trash? When I got you a place here to lay low, that's exactly what you were supposed to do. Lay low. Now there's a body in the trash.
I'm sorry, Grandma.
What would your grandfather say?
I'm sorry.
Now tell your friend to go home.
You better go, man. I'll leave your message at the lab kiss.
It better be a miracle. It better be a goddamn solid gold miracle shit, Tools.
Jesus, Art, you'll never guess.
You'd be surprised.
The body in there is Sniff's brother.
Fuck. And where's Sniff now?
In his apartment.
Okay. Let's call in the crew.
I got it. What a night, hey, Art?
Like you wouldn't believe.
Artie, you got a call on line two? Been on hold for 20 minutes.
Thanks, darling. Hello?
Hey, Artie, you'll never guess.
What the fuck, Jim? I told you to call the Labkus.
Ah, damn it. I'm sorry.
This better be good.
It's great. I can get my $5,000.
How's that?
I faked my own death, Artie. Kerman, that guy that owns the diner gave me a bunch of rotten pigs. I cut him up and dumped him in the river wrapped in my jacket.
That's not bad news. We can work with that. I'll inform the next of kin.
Thank you for listening to episode 4 of Sniff PI. If you'd like to keep up to date with the show, you can follow us on Twitter at SniffPI, and you can also visit our website where you can find scripts of the show, as well as our new podcast side project called Trailer Park, which is absolutely real, authentic trailers, because we are the exclusive getters in this business. So you can find us there at sniffpi.com. A huge thank you to Scott Manley, who portrayed Alan Kerman, the owner of the diner Jim has a run-in with. You can find Scott on his YouTube channel, where he does great videos for the game Kerbal Space Program. If you're looking to play the game and you don't know where to start, or you play the game and you're not very good, Scott has a series of beginner's tutorials that will really help you through the process. So search him on YouTube. His name is Scott and he is Scottish, so you should be able to find him pretty easily. You can also follow him on Twitter at DJSNM. And also to the wonderful Leara Morris-Clark as Mrs. Minkle, Agent Stillwater, and apparently the only female officer in the city precinct. You can find her at leara-clark.wix.com/leara-voice and on Twitter at leara-voice. If you need a voice actress, she's the person to go to. She is incredible. If you're interested in us as people, rather than just podcast creating meat, you can follow me at Beau D. Byrnes on Twitter and Connor at Condog on Twitter. And Connor's other podcast is back, Counselor George, the only monkey attorney in space. I play Uncle Buddy on there, so you should check it out, because it involves me. Nothing to do with Connor.
This summer.
So everybody, this is the house.
From a producer who owed a guy a favor.
This is the living room, through the hallway, to the kitchen. Say hello, sweetie.
Sweetie.
Come on, say hi.
Hi.
There we go.
Two newlyweds realized that a honeymoon cannot last forever.
This is my office.
Our shared office, thank you very much.
Yeah, that's right. We share an office. There's my doctorate there.
And here's my certification in cosmetology.
As they are plunged into a new level of darkness.
Oh, wait a second. I think I forgot to take the lens cap off.
So we've just lost all of today's memories?
I guess. Sorry.
I can't believe you.
Lens cap.
Do you think maybe we could fake it?